DNA is perfect for the storage and readout of genetic information. This information is stored in the sequence of adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine, also called A, T, G, and C. Each helix has a backbone made of alternating deoxyribose and phosphate groups. Readout occurs in the 3' to 5' direction, making use of the pairing of bases between the opposing strands of the DNA double helix. In these pairings, A pairs with T and G pairs with C via sets of complementary hydrogen bonds. The edges of the base pairs are exposed in the two grooves of the double helix, the wider major groove and the narrower minor groove. These edges are also used to carry information that is read by proteins that interact with the double helix. Prime example of a DNA double helix is PDB entry 1BNA. Upon printing the DNA folding template, you will notice that it contains two types of models. In this model, you can add your own base pairs, but be sure to pair them up properly. This detailed model shows all the atoms in each nucleotide. In this tutorial, we will use the smaller model for the demonstration. However, the technique is the same for both models. First, cut out the model. Fold all long, solid, gray lines so that each solid line is visible on the top edge of the crease that is made. Fold all long dotted gray lines so that each long dotted line is hidden within the crease that is made. Fold the paper in half so that the outer two backbone columns stack one over the other. Tuck the other backbone flaps with 5' at the top, one over the other. Next, temporarily fold the backbones so that the model is flat. Crease the horizontal and diagonal lines. Solid lines should be visible on the top edge of each crease, with dotted lines on the inside. You can crease them in any order you like, folding and unfolding each in turn. One good way to do it is to crease all of the horizontal lines, then flip the model over and crease all of the diagonal lines. The result should look sort of like a paper fan. Using the creases that you just made, fold out triangles that stack on top of each other, but not directly. This way, the triangle beneath the one just folded should rotate a little bit further clockwise, and as this process continues, the triangles in the spiraling ladder will form the circle structure. Your model should look like this when all the lines have been folded. Pull the model open and pop out the backbones on the sides. Your finished model is a right-handed double helix. You can use the tabs to connect several models to make longer strands. To learn more about DNA, go to pdb101.rcsb.org.